welcome to First Things First. I'm Jenna Wolf. That is Chris Canty in for Chris Carter. This right here is Nick Wright. Quick pause before we start to wish both of my parents a happy birthday this week.
That means today's the dad's birthday. Yesterday was the mom's birthday. Forgot to wish the mom a happy birthday.
Couldn't
wish the dad a happy birthday without wishing the mom a happy birthday. So now she's lumping them all into that birthday week.
Anyone else celebrating a birthday?
Thing with Jenna, yeah. Happy birthday. Dad more
than mom got snubbed. Mom got snubbed.
None of those things happen. There is never but happy birthday to both of you. Love you both to death. Never a dull moment in the NFL as we begin our three-hour program this morning. Dak Prescott is putting the rest of the league on notice that after beating the 2-7 Giants, Cam Newton's time in Carolina might be over. We'll let you know where he could end up next if he does leave. And in the NBA, they call him the king for a reason. That's where we start this morning. LeBron James reclaiming his throne this season. Lakers in Chicago last night where they beat the Bulls for their sixth straight win. For LeBron, 30 points, 10 rebounds, 11 assists. You know what that is. That is a triple-double, Canny. Three straight triple-doubles for the guy some said had started to decline after last season. First Laker since Magic Johnson to accomplish that feat. How is this happening for LeBron in year 17? Take a listen.
Being a triple threat on the floor, you know, I trust my teammates to make shots. I just try to put the ball on time and on target. And they've been doing that defensively, you know, trying to, you know, rebound as much as I can, even though I'm playing a point guard position. And then scoring, just trying to, you know, read the defense, you know, take, you know, pick my spots, you know, and just trying to be aggressive. So, you know, it comes with team success for me. You know, a triple-double means absolutely nothing to me if it's not in a win. You know, this is three wins for us, and I feel pretty, you know, happy about the way we performed.
Pretty happy, and then maybe a couple of other a little emotions here. LeBron then tweeting this to his haters, hashtag washed king. All right, Nick, is LeBron back to being not just perhaps the revengeful, angry player that he's never going to be because he's a nice guy, but being the best player in the NBA right now?
Well, the only issue I would take with the question is the word back in it. I would posit he never left being the best player in basketball. Now, he was injured, and when you're injured, you don't have the ability to show it. But yeah, LeBron, for the better part of 14 straight years now, has been the best player in the league. And someone's going to have to snatch that from him. And yesterday's win was an oddly really good win for the Lakers.
Yes.
Because they played so incredibly poorly for three quarters to a bad Bulls team. That LeBron had 28, 9, and 6 through three quarters. And that just barely kept them in it. It took a fourth quarter run that I know you're going to get into that really put the Lakers in position to get a win that should have never been in question. The Bulls are a building young team with a question mark at head coach and question marks all over the roster. So it shouldn't have taken a great LeBron James game for them to win, but it did. And he, of course, provided it. And for those that want to argue, no, LeBron's not the best player in basketball, my only question would be, well, then who is? Mm-hmm. Kevin Durant is out for the season. He was on his way to taking what he feels is his rightful place, and it's not his fault, but unfortunately his Achilles snapped on him, and so we can't see him outside of that Golden State ecosystem for another full year. Kawhi is already load managing, and he's doing it again tonight. That'll be 25% of the season. Kawhi Leonard just said, nah, don't need to play. Just like last year, 25% of the season, he said, nah, don't need to play. The closest competition, to my eye, is Giannis. Mm-hmm. And Giannis was the one who last year looked like he was going to take it, winning league MVP. Team had the best record. But if you're going to be considered the best player in the NBA, you don't have to have won a championship, but you have to have gone on at least one epic playoff run. Giannis missed that opportunity last year, so it's going to be hard for him, even though he's the guy I think will eventually take the crown from LeBron. Mm-hmm. It's going to be hard for him to win over the public until he goes on like LeBron did in 07, a playoff run that was unlike anything we'd seen in recent history, even though it didn't win in a title. So, yeah, he's the best player in the league. And if you watch a game like last night, Canny, he's controlling every aspect of the game on both ends like the best player in the league is supposed to.
No, he was controlling every aspect of the
the game. You see him on offense. He's controlling the tempo. It looks like a functional offense when he's out there handling the ball. Now, I know a lot of people have concerns about him being so ball dominant and the Lakers needing him to do that. But when you have Anthony Davis playing the way that he's playing, and then the guys on the bench playing the way that they were playing, especially last night and late in that third quarter and into that fourth quarter, that to me was probably the most impressive part about the win. I mean, you're talking about this team being down by as many as 19 in the third quarter, cut it to 13 at the end of the third quarter, go on a 14-0 run at the beginning of the fourth quarter, which was led by Kyle Kuzma and Quinn Cook. And you look at that team being able to do that, those guys coming off the bench, Kyle Kuzma coming off the ankle injury. They wanted to restrict his minutes last night, but when you looked at the bench and saw LeBron James and Anthony Davis reacting to him, you could see that they were excited about it because they know how important Kyle Kuzma is going to be to this team if they're going to accomplish their ultimate goal. Now, the only question remains is, can they do it against better competition when you're managing LeBron James and Anthony Davis's minutes? Now, Anthony Davis was on the bench for a completely different reason. He got into a little bit of foul trouble last night. But LeBron James, Frank Vogel talked about it after the game, he wasn't going to extend LeBron James in that game. So it was going to have to be some other guys to step up, and those other guys did step up. Even Dwight Howard, he played well on both sides of the court. The big block against Kobe White, being able to get an old-fashioned three-point play late in that game. Alex Caruso, he had another great play. He got the steal on Zach LaVine, ended up getting the old-fashioned three-point play. So I look at those guys and those types of contributions. That's what it's going to take for the Lakers to accomplish their ultimate goal, which is winning a title.
You know, Nick, the reason I think that you're in the minority in thinking LeBron never left as being the best player in the NBA is because I'm not sure LeBron even fully believes that. He came out of the gate, I mean, obviously rested from having all of last year to rest in the postseason and whatnot, but almost as if he had something to prove. I want to come out strong. I want to get my teammates involved. I want to lead the league in assists. I want triple doubles. And then he followed it up on social media, where if you know LeBron, a lot of what he's really thinking, he sort of puts out on social media. He's angry at someone. He's upset. He wants to prove something to someone.
Yeah, I think that there
is he trying to make a point?
Well, I think there was an element of, really? I do this for 15 straight years. I'm healthy for 15 straight years. I go to 8 straight NBA finals. And then I go to a team that we all acknowledged was not going to be able to win a championship in year one, that it was going to be a process in year one. I have them third in the West on Christmas Day, whooping the defending champ Golden State Warriors.
And then
my groin pops. Yeah. And now all of a sudden people act like, well, you know what I mean? Maybe I'll be an all-star. And so I think, if I were him, I'd be annoyed. I know we are all so myopic and we're all so what have you done for me lately, but to act like you have built up no, not even credibility, but no margin of error and no reasonable doubt as far as, okay, once he gets healthy, he'll get back to being the guy he has been since year two. Yeah, I'd be angry if I were him. I'd be irritated if I were him. And so I don't think he is out there gunning for triple doubles. I think he knows the way to remind everyone is not only the individual stat sheet, but you look at the NBA standings today. Oh, the Lakers have the best record in the league with the best point differential in the league. That's the way to remind everyone he's retaken his rightful place as the best player in basketball.
No, you're right. That is the way to remind everyone. But I feel like because LeBron James has been so great for so long and we haven't seen somebody with his athleticism and his overall physicality in his game be able to sustain that level of play as they get or later and later into their 30s, I think everybody wants to be the first one to the party to say LeBron James has lost it as the best player in the NBA.
The same way everyone tried to do with Tom Brady, and then he had that resurgence.
That's exactly right, Jenna. For some reason, because those guys have been great and they've been able to sustain that level of play, people want to be the ones to predict when they're going to fall off. But LeBron James, I mean, you saw the injury that happened throughout the season last year with the groin, and we just knew that he was dealing with some health concerns. But there's an explanation for that. I mean, over the course of the last 7 or 8 years, nobody has played more basketball in terms of minutes and games than LeBron James. So, I mean, everybody has to understand at some point that takes a toll, but it's whether or not LeBron James can recover and get back to that level of play. And I think he's showing that. Granted, it's a small sample size, but he's showing us that early this season.
If people can act like they can try to change the question or they can try to act like this isn't the obvious point, but right now, this moment, if every player in the league were available to you, and you were talking about for this year and this year only, every single GM in basketball would say, give me 23 for the Lakers. I will start there and work backwards. Not Anthony Davis, not Harden, not Kawhi. Steph's on the rack. Certainly not Jokic, all these guys that were like, oh, he's the next guy. If you had one for this season, if you can have any player in the
over
league.
Over Giannis?
The answer, even over Giannis, because now Giannis is the closest competition, I feel, but because you know there isn't an answer for him come the postseason, Giannis also showed that. I think Giannis would be the close second, and if you were to extend the timeline, Giannis would become the first pick. But for this season, for the
LeBron
16th straight year, he would be the guy you would take.
I think you make a good point. A lot of people want to be first to the table to say this is it. And let me just say, I think we've seen the beginning of the end for Zion Williamson. I just want to be the first. Coming up, as Cam Newton played his last game for the Panthers, that's next on FS1. You can always